What's going on, Madden family? This is your boy, Jmoneygood. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel and you like the content after the video, do me a favor, subscribe and turn your notifications on so you can be notified when my content drops, because when I drop coin methods that are fire, I drop them at the time that they are fire for me. So hopefully you guys can gain something out of it. All right, guys, we do Friday night giveaways. Last week we gave away Josh Allen. We gave away a $15 Xbox gift card and an LT. Okay, guys, this week we'll be giving away a Darrelle Revis. So if you would like to be entered to win Darrelle Revis, one of the top corners in Madden 21 right now, smack the thumbs up, comment, make sure you're subscribed, and turn your notifications on, man. All right, guys, because the guys that comment, and I see that, sometimes I handpick my winners from the content, from the comment section, guys. So you want to make sure that you're commenting on my videos. Just comment on one during the week, and that will give you a better chance to win when I handpick my winners from the comments that I enjoy to read. I love to give back to my people that love to give back to me. All right, guys, so we have a lot going on in Madden right now. Okay, guys, we have Blitz coming up on Thursday midnight, possibly Friday day. It all depends on when they're going to drop it. Kralo is going to let us know. As soon as I find out, I will let you guys know. But there are events right now that you could be completing to get yourself ahead of the game. Okay, guys, and it's the Turkey Bowl solos. Now, I've made a video on how to beat these during one of my coin methods. Okay, guys, now with these solos, guys, you always want to see who you could sub in, okay? Especially for like the passing and like, you know, even the running. Every solo, you want to see who can run in, sub in, because with mine, I was either able to sub in two wide receivers at a time or one wide receiver and a guard. And it helped me beat these solos because these solos are pretty complicated to do, guys. I'm not going to lie. It took me about an hour and a half, 2 hours to complete these. So make sure you guys are subbing in the players that you could sub in. That will help you. We need every single Blitz Bolt, guys, because the Blitz Bolts really count. There's going to be events that are going to be dropping throughout the night, possibly in previous ones. This is what happened, and you're going to have to play those solos. But guess what, guys? We're not going to be up at 2, 4, 8 in the morning. Some of us have kids. Some of us had jobs. Some of us can make it. Some of us will set our alarm and get every single Blitz Bolt. And my grinders that could do that, man, more power to you. I know I always miss a couple, and then you have to wind up buying them, or else you won't even be able to use the Blitz joints that you got. You might be able to use it in a smaller set, but you won't be able to get the boss card that you want. This set is based around money, guys, but you do not have to spend money. Listen to me now, guys. You do not have to spend money on the Blitz promo, guys, because what you could do is be getting your coins up and getting prepared for events like this that are about to come into the game. And the best way that you could do it is if you guys have a team that's worth selling off, okay? Sell off the players that you could actually get rid of, but keep your team to an extent where you're not going to be destroyed in the game of Madden, where you could still compete, okay, guys? Like, I have a lot of extra players I could sell off, like Derek Brooks, Shazier. I got a ton of cards that I could sell off. Now, this Darren Waller, guys, I might even sell my Darren Waller off, because remember, guys, Eric Ebron has a chance to become a 93 overall, and he's only going for 129 right now. This is a card that I suggest you guys pick up right now. Now, the Marquise Hollywood Brown, guys, he literally single-handedly destroyed my fantasy this week, so I'm not going to suggest you pick him up, guys. He had zero catches, and he had two targets, so this guy is really touch and go. If you want to invest in Marquise Hollywood Brown, he will be the fastest card in the game for a brief period until Tyreek Hill does drop, all right, guys? So he's going to turn to a 93 if he does complete 60 receiving yards with one touchdown. But like I said, guys, I have no faith in Marquise Hollywood Brown. He trashed me this weekend. All I needed was 2 points from the guy, and I would have won both of my leagues. And guess what, guys? He let me down. He didn't have one receiving catch. I don't know what's going on in Baltimore, but if you guys have fantasy in Baltimore besides Lamar Jackson, I suggest you don't deal with it, all right, guys? But anyway, these are some cards that you can invest in. Now, also, if you guys invested in the Tyreek Hill gold, this is why you guys have to have your notifications turned on, okay? Because when I drop tips like this, guys, if you would invest, not his gold, his elite, his Tyreek Hill elite, if you notice, his card's already up to 50,000 coins, okay? Based off of the hype that Poodle and your boy Xerxy made earlier, because they think that he's going to get Team of the Week. I still think he's going to come out of the Blitz event, but if he comes out of the Team of the Week, if he's a limited, it's going to suck. But if he's a card that we could put in the set and complete, we will be able to make tons of coins off of that, guys. You know how we make coins off of Team of the Week, okay? That's another thing that's coming. Now, look, this card, you could already make 30,000. Well, we were getting him for 25,000. He's up 25,000 coins already. We could sell him off and make 25,000 coins profit. I wish I would have picked up more when he was down low. He's already up high. Okay, guys, so if you need this card before he comes out, you do not have this elite, pick it up now, guys, because this 87 is going to go up to maybe possibly 200,000 coins. They start to get rarer in the towards the middle and end of the year, and some of these cards can gain a good value, okay? With his power up, I suggest you guys pick his power up too, just to have, all right? You're going to need a Tyreek Hill power up if you don't have one already. Just because if he doesn't come in a set, guys, you want to be able to put him up on the market and make tons of coins. Look at his power up, is already up 25,000 coins. So if you invested when I told you to, guys, you already made 50,000 coins. I made 50,000 coins if I sell off right now. But I'm going to hold mine, actually, guys, because I have a feeling that this card is only just starting to increase in value. If we find out that he's getting a Team of the Week card, guys, guess what? It's hit. It's going to go up major in price, okay? Now, we have Team of the Week dropping, and there is a possible chance that we could get Tyreek Hill. Okay, Keenan Allen, and also Cam Jordan, guys. Now, if you guys remember Cam Jordan, he was one of the budget beasts that I mentioned earlier on in one of my videos, guys. And I suggest if you need a budget beast, if you want to sell off your ends for the Blitz promo to get some coin, this is a good guy to have, okay? Because, look, he already powers all the way up to a 91 overall, guys. Now, if he gets a plus one because he had a good game, he'll be a 92 overall, and he'll be made with training, guys. So it's an absolute budget beast, a good add to your team. And the card is going to play relatively decent, okay? I have Jack Youngblood at that position. Jack Youngblood is the best in the game. You don't need any abilities on Jack. And guess what? He's going to be in there getting the quarterback. But like as I said, guys, if you can't afford Jack, go get yourself this Cam Jordan, guys. His power-up is relatively cheap, okay? Now, if his power-up doesn't come in the set and he does get a plus one, look at that, 2,000 coins, guys, okay? So I'm going to grab one more of these just in case he does get a power-up without the without his power-up in the set. And we might be able to sell these for a higher price. Actually, I'm going to grab one more because Cameron Jordan could be a glitchy card. I don't see it as a meta card, but maybe I might be able to earn some profit on it, okay? So these are small things you guys want to stay ahead of the game, okay? Like I said, guys, we have Team of the Week dropping tomorrow. And Team of the Week is always lucrative for us, guys, because what we do is we create the players. We snipe and get the players, the players that go into the ball set for as cheap as possible. And we try and create these players and put them on the market to sell to make profit, because there's always a large gap between what they cost and what they sell for. For some reason, we always make tons of coins. Now, right now, guys, because I gave this method out to all of you, it is kind of run down into the ground. But like if I were to snipe these three for 20, all I got to do is get two of these for about 80K, and then buy these ones down here for cheap and put them up on the market, flip them and sell them, all right? And I can make profit off of that, okay? It is the easiest way to make profit. But for you guys that don't have a lot of coins, okay, guys, listen, if you do not have a lot of coins, guys, get into the Team of the Week. The get a player method, guys, all right? Now, the get a player method, you could do a lot of things with this, man. You could just sit here and do the get a player method, guys, and you could sell everything off if you don't want to get involved in any type of risky coin methods. This is an easy one, okay, because you're going to pull a lot of power-ups. You're going to pull a lot of elites out of here. And also, this get a player method, okay, which is the get a player method, is you exchange all the way up in the high golds, guys, okay? All right, and you try and stabilize your coins while you're doing it. Like, say if you make 50K worth of these, then you want to sell off like 40, 50K worth of stuff. So that way you're not losing any coins and you're just gaining cards for free, okay? We need those 75s, guys. What are we going to do with the 75s? You guys already know. We're going to be adding them into weeks 1 and 2 of the team of the week, okay? All right, because we want to be creating those team of the week players because they're back up in profit. So this coin method is active right now. Okay, all we got to do is drop the golds in here. Let me see if I have enough. I probably have elites. It's probably counting my elites. All right, so we got golds. All right, so let's check it out. Let's see if we can get one. Now, these are 78s and 79s. Guys, I should be saving these for the set that's going to drop tomorrow. But, of course, I always like to try and give you guys an example when I can. Hold on. Let's see if we have any lower golds than that, which we might. All right, cool. We do, actually. All right. So you just do the get a player method until you have enough golds to open these packs, guys. Now, you only want to put your 75s and 76s into this set, and these cards sell up for about like 6,000 to 9,000 coins depending on which way the market is fluctuating, guys. But if you want to get ahead of the game and say we do get a Tyreek Hill master set tomorrow, guys, we want to create those 75 through 79. Now, it is a lot, okay, guys? It definitely is a lot. It's 78s now, excuse me. So it's 78s through 79s, and you need 16 of them, which is an awful lot, okay? But say if we do get a good MasterCard and you guys are prepared, go sit there and do the get a player method. Sell off your elites, sell off your power-ups, put your 77s through 75s in a team in the week 1 and 2. Either that, or you can put your 77s that you get into the 50 players, and you guys could be creating the 50 players through the get a player method. All right, guys, because remember, these cards sell on average for about 20,000 coins. All right, and they take 77 overalls, okay? So our 77 overalls we want to put into this set, and then we could sell our 83s for 20,000 coins. All right, if we don't have a lot of coins, we want to be doing that method. All right, also remember, we could be putting them in the team of the week set. All right, now if you also want to be prepared, guys, and you want to have your high gold, your 78s ready for the new set that's going to drop tomorrow, it could get you ahead of the game if you wind up pulling a high overall card. Now, if you guys don't pull a high overall card, I don't know what the low golds are going to be going for. You could either, you have, what is it? It's a one, so you got 80 overall, you got like, what, an 84 overall, and then you got like an 89 overall that's going to go in a set. So if you pull like the 84 or 86 that's going to be in the set, you're going to make profit. If you pull the 89 that goes into the ball set, you're going to make profit. But if you wind up pulling one of the low 80s, you can lose profit, okay? But not if you do the get a player method and stabilize your coins, so that way you make free cards, if you guys understand what I mean. If you don't, write in the comments section and I will help you out, guys. All right, but we always can make coins off a team of the week. Like I said, guys, you want to be a creator. I say this in every video, guys. You know I gotta hook you up with this info. We want to snipe and create these sets and put them on the block. All right, now as soon as the cards come out, you cannot do this method because it's so muddied up from people pulling the boss sets out of the packs. All right, now people do need the power-ups. So that's why the set becomes lucrative. Okay, so if I pulled this 92 heap, I want his power up. I just go on the market and buy it instead of creating his set, okay? Where my guys, you guys, want to be looking to create these sets, sell them and put them on the block. We already know this because I know you guys are doing it because the set's all beat up. The team of the week's all beat up. Plus, nobody's opening packs right now, okay, guys? All right, so we're going to make tons of coins off of this team of the week. That's what's going to set us up for the blitz. All right, guys, like I said, we want to be selling off most of our team, whatever we can sell off to save some profit. Like me, guys, I like to pick up these cards. Now, Melvin Gordon has a high chance to become a team of the week player tomorrow, even though he does have a 93. he could be due for a plus one. So I picked this card up. This is what I call a low-risk card, guys. Now, if he gets that 94 overall, he'll become a 95 overall, and he'll be the most powerful back in the game if he gets a plus one tomorrow. And I picked him up. He does have this limited card, so I don't really think he's going to get the plus one. But it was predicted through your boy Poodle and Xerxy that he would. So they're usually pretty good at what they do, and I trust them. So I'm going to try it. And if not, it's a low-risk card. I would lose 50,000 coins. Not a big deal. I would just quick sell it, all right? But powered up, this card should be pretty good. So if he does get a plus one, guys, maybe I'll do a gameplay video, guys, for you guys tomorrow. I'll do a gameplay with the Melvin Gordon, all right? But we could see a Tyreek Hill tomorrow, guys. I don't think so. Like I said, I don't think we're going to see a Tyreek Hill. All right, but remember this 87 overall. Look, it's dropping down a little bit in price because it's starting to sell off of hype, okay? Do I suggest you pick one of these up? Yes, because this card could wind up becoming very profitable. It's already up 25K from yesterday. The same with this power-up. We could get a set that gives his power-up. All right, so his power-up could become worthless, but it's a risk that I'm willing to take, guys, okay? Now, like I said, the market's starting to stabilize. So by tomorrow or tonight, sell your cards off, guys. All right, look, I just picked up this Cliff Harris. You guys want to see his stats powered up? So he's now the best free safety in the game. He's way faster than Ronnie Lott. He cost a good amount of coins, but I got him during the weekend, and I snagged him up. He's now starting. I got Brian Dawkins as, like, my run stopper. I'm going to have him and Mays in the box. And Lott and Cliff Harris up top. And I'll probably run Polamalu at cornerback. I like safeties on the field, guys. The more safeties, the merrier. You know what I mean? But, yeah, guys, so prepare for Team of the Week. But remember, guys, the big thing, we don't want to take our minds off of his blitz. We don't want to go crazy. We want to have coins, guys, okay? So do some coin methods. Go back. If you need methods, you guys can look at my previous methods on how to get some free training. There's, like I say, people aren't pulling a lot of packs right now. But let's go back, check out the archive, right? What's his name? The white boy, that's a good wide receiver. He's in this set. Is that him right there? Adam Thielen, yeah. Adam Thielen, guys, has a good chance of getting a plus one tomorrow. So we want to take a look at this set for tomorrow. Not today. Now, you guys can make one of these cheap by going underneath and building this from the 90s. See, he's going for 90,000 coins. He's already starting to get on the hype train. Look at that. So that's 33 right there. So what's that? 66 so far. All right. And what do these guys go for? 76. All right, so I guess it's cheaper to buy them up top right now, okay? But if this card does inflate tomorrow, guys, in price, remember we could always go underneath. Like I said, he's starting to get on the hype train already because he had an amazing week, and he was predicted to be in the Team of the Week by some good streamers, all right, guys? So remember, tomorrow we might be able to come back to this set and make this set and sell off that card. That might be a good method if we see that card rise in price for tomorrow, guys. Okay, now you guys could always be doing the free training method. Remember, you make one of these players and you go over and you roll the leaves, all the bad pools that you get. I can give you an example real quick, just a small one, okay, because I don't want to get into it too long. Look, he's already starting to go. People are trying to get their free training through my free training method that I dropped last week. You guys can always go back and watch my previous videos because they're going to have some type of tips in them. Okay, guys. All right. So we made what we did is basically we made Aaron Donald. All right. And we just made him for 270. He's selling for 240. So we're going to take like a 40K loss. But what you could do to stabilize that loss, so you're just gaining training, is go over to the Autumn Blast training section, okay? And what you guys can do right here is when you guys get a bad pull, all right? Like this 83, guys, we could sell this off, but I'm just going to save this because I'm going to need this to put into the 86 overall team builder, okay? Now, all we need is three more All we need is three more 80s. Okay, so let's see. They're probably going to let me pull three 80s in a row. But I don't know. They nerfed this pack. Some people seem like they're making coins. Mostly my Xbox guys. Now, look, we could sell that one off right there. I got some type of an award. We could sell that one off right there, guys. Or you could turn it into leaves if you still want to roll for leaves. All right. Oh, they're just giving us 83s now, guys, so I don't know. Looks like we're going to make tons of coins off of this. So can we cover 70K? All right. There we go. That's 180 right there. Put in an 86. Now we just need two more 80s. Now you guys can either sell everything off or if you want to make free leafs out of this. But this is how you guys make this set for free right here. This is how you get free training, free leafs. Okay. It's just up to you what you want to do. Usually I do quick sell the 81 overalls. But for the sake of the video, guys, I'm not going to do that. All right, so we need one more 80. We could sell off those two 83s. Plus, we still have 3,000 training because we completed this set. And we lost, remember, we lost about, what? We lost about 40,000 coins completing this set. We go over to 86 overall, guys. We make one of these out of these pools. Oh, I thought that was it right there. All right, one more 80, guys, that we need. Watch me get an 84 now. 82. All right, so we do not sell off our 82s. I mean, we sell off our 82s, guys, or we quick sell them. We do not add them into the set. Now, look, we're down to 2,000 training right now, guys. Now we got another 80 overall. That's perfect for this method right here. All right, and add them up to the 86 team builders. Now we're going to get one of them, okay? Now, if you want free leaves, you just quick sell this one. But what you guys want to do to make your coins back, to make this a free method, is we want to be selling off the 86, all right, guys? And like I said, I usually sell off this boy right here. He's a budget beast. He's very fast. He goes to a Raiders theme team, so he sells pretty good. All right, so we sold off our... We did the Aaron Donald. He's still up on the auction block. He has to sell. Remember, we lost about 40,000 coins from creating him. We quick sold the 290 overalls that we got from completing the ball set. We got the 5,000 training. We rolled it into the leaves, okay, guys? All right, so look at that. We lost 40K profit from creating the Aaron Donald. All we do is post this up here. We're going to post them up for about 29,000. You know, we're just going to post them up for 30 even. All right, so we'll get 27 back. That's perfect. All right. See how this method becomes free? Now you just earn 2,500 training for free, and you also covered the loss of years. You know, I could quick sell these, or I can make my profit back. For the sake of the video, I'm going to sell them. All right. So what's that? 35. All right. We sell one of these guys. All right. He's going for 8,000. Looks like they're selling for, yeah, 8,800. And now after I sell this card, guys, this covers the loss for the Aaron Donald. So now we have 2,500 training for free, and we also have an extra 83. Now we could either sell this to make 8,000 coins, or we could just quick sell it to roll some leaves. Now I have 2,534 training for free. I have 1,300 leaves for free. Okay, guys. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna roll into the big set one time. I have my 2,500 training for free. I'm gonna roll the Autumn Blast set one time. Nothing big, an 86. Now I'm gonna sell this off, guys. So now I just made about 10,000 coins profit from the Aaron Donald, and I also got 2,534 training left over for free. Okay, guys, so you just got to get in and you got to snipe that Aaron Donald, or you could do this. Look, actually, we made 24,000 off of this. Okay, so we made about 20,000 profit off of creating the Aaron Donald and selling him and doing this method, and then we also have training left over. And we're going to repeat this process over and over, and guys, until we build up about 20,000 free training. Okay, now this is going to take a little bit, but remember, guys, this is free training, and you're going to need training because there could be packs like Fire Fantasy packs for training. They have done it in years past, guys, okay? And then people are running out to get training, and the whole market rises up. Join the Blitz promo, and then once the packs are open, it drops down in price. They go up and down, up and down. You never know what you could get with the Blitz promo, but you want to have training going into it just to be safe, guys, all right? This is your boy, Jmoneygood, giving you advice on the Blitz promo, giving you advice on Team of the Week, and we're doing giveaways on Friday night. Like I said, we had 3 giveaways last week. We'll see what we can do for Blitz Friday night, but we are giving away Darrelle Revis. If you like the content, you're new, subscribe. Do me a favor, smack the thumbs up, get this video to 30 likes. We will give away an Aaron Donald. This is your boy, Jmoneygood. Turn your notification on to stay up to date with all the best coin methods and all the top giveaways in Madden 21 today. This is your boy, Jmoneygood. Much love. Peace.